Welcome to this video demonstration of sputum smear examination for diagnosis of tuberculosis. Smear microscopy is a century-old technique. It is a basic diagnostic tool for TB. It requires minimal infrastructure. It is simple and inexpensive, offers quick results in less than 1 hour, and it is available at all levels, right from designated microscopy center to reference laboratories. A good quality sputum must be thick with mucoid or mucopurulent material, and volume of the sputum should be 3 to 5 ml to obtain a good result. Thin watery specimens, saliva and nasal secretions are not suitable for smear microscopy. There are two types of smear microscopy. One is the bright field microscopy using the Ziehl-Neilsen staining method. The next one is the fluorescent microscopy using the light emitting diode microscope using the fluorescent staining. We will now look at the preparation of the smear for microscopy. Here we have specimens with mucopurulent portion. We require a good scratch free clean slide for a good quality smear reading. The slide is labeled, and smear can be taken using any of the methods. We can either use a twisted 5 mm diameter nichrome wire loop or using a disposable 5 mm diameter loop. Both can be used at the reference laboratory, but in a peripheral lab like a DMC, we can use the broomstick or the loop, but this cannot be used whenever the specimen is also required for culture. Now, here we are going to make a smear using the disposable loop. A full drop from the mucopurulent portion of the sputum sample is taken on the loop, and it is spread on the slide. A gentle heating of the slide facilitates a good quality smear making. And here the smear is made using concentric circular motions at the periphery. This ensures that the bacilli in the sample is uniformly distributed in the smear. The smear should neither be thick nor thin. The smear is then left to air dry in the cabinet so that it is completely air dried and no aerosols are present when the smear is fixed using heat. Here we have completely air dried smear. We see the smear is completely air dried and it does not have any air bubbles or wet material. Fixing of the smear to the slide can be done by passing the smear 3 times over the flame or by keeping it on a hot plate at 95 degree for 5 minutes. It is now ready for staining. We will now be seeing the Ziehl-Neilsen staining method. The steps that are involved in Ziehl-Neilsen staining method are that first we flood the fixed smear using filtered carbolfuxin, which is the primary stain. The slide is heated gently from below till steam arises. This is left for about 7 to 10 minutes and the stain is then washed off with water gently. The smear is then flooded with 25% sulfuric acid for about 45 to 60 seconds and then washed with water gently, and then it is flooded with methylene blue and left for 45 seconds. After washing, it is allowed to dry. Once it is dried, a drop of liquid paraffin is placed on the smear and it is seen under the oil immersion objective of the microscope. These are the three staining solutions: 1% carbolfuxin, 25% sulfuric acid and 0.1% methylene blue. So, we have the fixed smear here that is to be stained. It is placed on the staining rack with a smear facing upward. The smear is flooded with carbalfuxin. Care is taken to see that the solution is not touched with the tube. This is left for 7 to 10 minutes and the smear is heated from under for about a few seconds until steam arises. At the end of 7 minutes or 10 minutes, the stain is washed off using water. The smear is then flooded with 25% sulfuric acid. This is for about 45 seconds to 1 minute. It is washed off using water and then the counter stain is applied, which is methylene blue. This restaining is applied for about 45 seconds to 60 seconds. After washing it off, the smear is air dried completely, or it can be left on a hot plate for drying. The smear is then seen under the oil immersion objective. A drop of liquid paraffin is added, placed on the stage of the microscope. This is how the organisms appear under the microscope once stained with Ziehl-Neilsen staining. They appear as pink beaded long thin rods against a blue background. And while reading the smear, grading is given for each smear. This is as per the WHO or IUATLD guideline. When no AFB is seen in 100 oil immersion fields, it is graded as negative. When 1 to 9 AFB per 100 oil immersion fields are seen, it is recorded as scanty. That is, the actual number of bacilli seen in 100 fields is written there and it is called positive. When 10 to 99 AFB is seen in 100 oil immersion fields, it is called 1 plus positive. If 1 to 10 AFB are seen per oil immersion field on an average of visualizing 50 fields, it is called as 2 plus positive. And if more than 10 AFB per oil immersion field is seen on an average of viewing 20 fields, then it is called as 3 plus positive. Next, we come to the fluorescence staining procedure. The steps that are involved are, first the smear is flooded with oramine phenol and it is left for about 7 minutes. After washing gently with water, the smear is flooded with acid alcohol for about 1 minute. This is for decolorizing the smear. After washing it gently with water, it is flooded with potassium permanganate for about 45 seconds. After washing with water and drying it completely, it is scanned under the low power dry objective and then read under the high power dry objective of the integrated LED microscope. These are the three solutions that are meant for staining. First is the 0.3% oramine phenol stain, which is the primary stain, followed by 1% acid alcohol, which is used for decolorizing, and then 0.1% potassium permanganate, which is used for restaining. So, we will now be seeing the staining procedure using this slide. The slide is placed on the rack with a smear facing upward. oramine phenol is added. Smear is flooded with the solution and left for about 7 minutes. This does not involve any heating. It is washed gently with water after 7 minutes. After draining off the water, we now flood it with the acid alcohol for decolorization of the smear. The acid alcohol is left for about 45 seconds. Again washed off with water. The smear is then flooded with the restaining solution, that is potassium permanganate. This is left for about 45 seconds, washed with water. The water is then drained and the slide is dried before it is seen under the microscope. So, this is seen under the eyelid microscope using the low power and high power objectives. The smear is first scanned using the low power objective. And then grading and confirmation of the smear morphology is done using the high power objective. This is how the organism appears under the LED microscope when stained by the fluorescence staining method. It appears as a bright yellow beaded slender rod against a black background. We use grading for fluorescence smear microscopy also as per the IUATLD WHO method or recommendation. So, this is the grading chart that is used for smears when stained by the FM method. Generally, the 400x magnification is used, in which one length is equal to 40 fields or 400 high power field. When no AFB is seen per length, that is about 40 fields, it is recorded as negative. When 1 to 19 AFB are seen per length, that is 40 fields, it is recorded as scanty and the actual number of bacilli seen in 40 fields is recorded. And if 20 to 199 AFB per length is seen, it is recorded as 1 plus. If 5 to 50 AFB per field is seen on an average, it is recorded as 2 plus. And if more than 50 AFB per field is seen on average, then it is recorded as 3 plus. We will now see the advantages and disadvantages of sputum smear microscopy. Advantages are that the method is very simple, it offers rapid results, it is very cost effective and it can be done in a peripheral laboratory. Disadvantages include the low sensitivity, especially in people living with HIV and extrapulmonary specimens. It cannot distinguish between live and dead bacilli, it cannot identify drug resistance. It cannot differentiate between mycobacterium tuberculosis complex and non-tuberculous mycobacteria, and false results are possible. With this, we come to the end of the video demonstration on sputum smear microscopy for diagnosis of TB. Thank you.